guys, Kat Kalm here with Studio Sweat On Demand. And of course, sidekick Bethany always
Hello.
Here. And then today we also have Mike Morrell with us. And he is an awesome swimmer. And Mike and his wife Karen own one of the most amazing swim schools in the area. The most amazing swim school.
Like in the country. Yes.
In the country.
Yes.
In the world.
They have multiple locations and it is called Floaty Swim School. And I wanted to bring Mike on today because we want to talk about swimming and triathlons. Okay, because we're coming into triathlon season. And what do you think the biggest fear is for someone who's new to the triathlon world?
Oh, I've heard from so many people, I will never do a triathlon. I am afraid of the swim. I won't swim, I can't swim.
Right, I mean, besides the fact that, you know, there's some numbers out there that say that 60% of adults in America can't swim to save their life. So, let alone that, to put them into an environment where they're actually racing and actually competing with other people in an open water environment can be terrifying.
Super scary.
Yeah.
Yeah. You feel like you're in an agitator. Speaking of agitator.
I am the agitator.
Yeah. Well, there's all those bodies around you. It's really challenging.
It's so really fun.
What advice do you have for someone who's thinking about doing a triathlon?
Well, I think you got to put people in two categories. Competent swimmers and then people that are just kind of swimming in the summertime for fun. If you're one of those type of swimmers where you're not really confident in the water, I think you need to get into a pool and really get a lot of practice time in. Maybe a good month or two before your triathlon, maybe even more. Twice a week, three times a week, get in there and really get confident in your stroke. If your triathlon happens to be in an open water swim, which is the bay or the ocean or a lake, you really need to be competent in a pool. Because once you lose that protection of the side wall or the lane line.
Being able to grab onto it.
Right, yeah. That can be a big fear factor. So I'd say a lot of good pool time first, and then take a couple practice runs at your course. You know, all the triathlons have courses online.
Yeah.
Get out there in your bay or your lake or your ocean and swim a few times like that. I know when you guys do your triathlon training, you had a couple days where we went out to the ocean and did open water swims to practice.
And maybe don't start with a beach entry because those are definitely the most challenging for most people. So make sure you know which triathlon you're doing as far as what type of swim it is. Is it a beach entry? Is it, meaning you're diving into the waves? Is it a bay entry, meaning you just kind of float in the water, you're
in
the bay?
Start in the water, yeah.
And then there's lake entries also. But even on the lake entry, sometimes you'll start on the shore and you'll have to run in. So know what's coming and you can usually figure that out when you look online. And make sure you pick the right race. So it's the freestyle stroke that most people do when they're swimming.
Correct.
Competitively for a triathlon especially, right?
Right.
Yeah. So would you suggest that they maybe, if they're brand new to swimming, would you suggest like a couple of one-on-one lessons if possible?
If you have someone in the area that can do a lesson, that'd be great if you're not a competent swimmer. Or you can always go and find a friend that is a swimmer.
Yeah.
You know, the triathlon world is a very small world where people will help other people out.
Yeah.
The freestyle stroke is a very easy stroke to learn, and if you thrashed around in the ocean before, you're probably and if you've probably done that, you're probably doing something close to a freestyle anyways.
Yeah.
Maybe just get someone who is a competent swimmer, who swam in the past, who's done triathlons, to look at your stroke and give you some tips
and tricks.
Does
floaties do, just for our local San Diego people, does floaties do adult training at
all? We do adult training in the evenings after our school's closed, plus our swim team we'll give private adult lessons too at the club, which is Stone Ridge Country Club.
And you guys are in Poway, and then also you're
Chula Vista. East Lake Chula Vista, which is East Chula Vista.
Okay.
If you come in there and you want to get some training, we'll definitely give you a one-on-one lesson. And as an adult, if you're not afraid of the water, it's just a matter of getting someone to look at your stroke, telling what you're doing wrong, and then you going and practicing it. So you don't need to buy some big package of 50 lessons.
Right.
It's not like teaching a child to swim where they're afraid of the water, they don't know the stroke. It's just a matter of getting them some tips
and mechanics.
Right. And then them doing it themselves on the side.
What muscles do you think you use the most as far as like if I want to strengthen my muscles for swimming, what muscles do you use the most in the freestyle stroke?
The muscle that you use the most that you don't use on a day-to-day basis would be your lats.
Okay.
You know, it all comes from the shoulders and the lats.
Yeah.
And I know you guys working out in here with the spin sculpt, you know, you do a lot of shoulders and stuff. There's not a lot of lat work. So you'll notice your lats will be sore. You'll start to really get some some definition in them also. That's where a lot of the strength and the pull down comes from.
I felt it in my tricep too when I was doing it. I was probably overcompensating for something else because I didn't know.
And that's probably good. You know, it's all that. If you're doing it right, it's that pull down motion.
Right.
So that's so like that's, a kickback,
yeah.
You know, tricep and lat, right. You know, all in there engaging, all in that area.
I felt like when I had my best stroke, my shoulders were fatigued.
Yeah. That's a great body rotation. I know you and I worked on your stroke a couple times and it really improved.
Yeah.
Rotating that body so you're using the torso and not so much of the shoulders.
Right, core strength.
Because if you get a full body turn into that, that'll help you kind of alleviate a little bit of the shoulders.
Yeah.
But again,
gives you longer to breathe too.
Longer to breathe, that's true. But again, in the end, you know, you're using some muscles that just don't normally get used.
Right.
So you're gonna feel it everywhere, I think. Yeah. Even in the shoulder muscles, it's probably a different shoulder muscle.
Oh, absolutely. You know? It was all new to me, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Bethany saw my first attempt at swimming, and it's actually really gotten a lot better. Thank you.
It's gotten a lot better.
Both of you guys, and I'm actually more confident in the open water now than I am in a pool, just because I don't have the kickflip. Anyways, enough about me. So thank you, Mike.
Thank you for sharing.
So stay here while we talk about the Studio Sweat On Demand releases that are coming out. Bethany, what do we have?
Oh my, we're going there.
Sunday,
Olga comes out with the TRX cardio that was filmed right now.
Ah.
Looks super fun, looks awesome, so be sure to get that done. And then you come out on Thursday with a spin sculpt.
Which I didn't realize, so that means I need to film that. When am I filming that?
Monday, I believe.
Okay, it's gonna be a good one.
All right.
Trainer tip of the week, conquer a fear this week. If you're scared to swim, sign up for a triathlon. There's different lengths.
Or a swim lesson.
No, I want you to
dive
in the pool. Don't dip that little pinky toe in.
Dive into the deep end.
Because you can, sorry, we're having our bait or we're sport fun. You can sign up for different length triathlons, by the way. There's sprint triathlons. There's the shortest, which is
super sprint.
Then, of course, the Olympic distance. And the swim in the Olympic is a mile.
A little under a mile, yeah, I think.
Okay.
Right at a mile.
And then the swim in a sprint is between 500 and 750 meters. And then in a super sprint, it's about 500 usually. Yeah. So
you'll be in and out of that water before you know what happened.
I say you try it. Yeah.
Or just the Ironman and go for the 2.1 miles.
I would love to do that. Just the swim part.
Yeah,
just the swim part. And then the 100 mile bike would probably get me, but.
I'd like to do the swim and the bike and the run.
Mm-mm. You don't want to do the run.
No, I'll be driving.
The marathon.
Mike can swim like mile after mile after mile and not even be winded. Right? What did you do that one day?
That one day, for the fundraiser? For the fundraiser, we did a 3,000 yards, so close to 2 miles.
Nice.
In about 35, 40 minutes.
You have to pace yourself.
Just a long pace.
I think my arms
it's like jogging. It's like at that point, it's just like jogging. You know, you're not sprinting. You're not walking.
Did you have to count your laps, or was somebody counting them for you?
I had a lap counter.
Oh,
okay, good.
Because I
was like, what number was I on?
I had a real reliable 8-year-old counting my laps.
That's awesome.
So could he have like fudged the numbers?
No, I made sure he was trying to under fudge them. You know, he's counting. Oh, was that 2 or 6, Dad? I'm like, that was 6. He's like, okay.
He's like, all right, that was 7.
I thought that was 2.
Okay, are you guys ready to wrap this up?
Okay, sorry.
We'll finish this conversation later. You guys have an awesome week.
Bye.